Hello. And in just a few moments, it's Bridge Building Today, a brand new technology series in which we highlight some of the biggest and best bridge building projects around the world. To begin this series, we'll be following the much-heralded multi-billion pound Edwards Memorial Bridge, soon to be constructed in Chilwell near Nottingham. Part 1. How long is my span?
For years, bridges of all shapes and sizes have been a part of Britain's national heritage. Our bridge builders have been celebrated as heroes the length and breadth of the land. George Isambard Kingdom Edwards is renowned as one of Europe's foremost bridge design and construction engineers, a throwback to a golden age of bridge building. He's recently submitted an application to planning authorities for the construction of a massive new viaduct, a spectacular sweeping structure that will enable traffic to cross from the fourth tee at Chilwell Manor Golf Club to the semi-rough on the far bank of a yawning chasm, a journey which has previously necessitated an arduous four-hour ferry crossing. George Edwards' immense span is thought to be at least 400 centimetres in length. Like many engineering geniuses, George Edwards' initial blueprint was fairly basic. He soon realised, however, that to build a bridge with the pinpoint precision required today, not to mention all the building regulations involved, demands the very latest in 3D computer-aided design equipment. So, in order to produce the sophisticated plans he needs, George has invested heavily in new technology. Edwards is constructing this monstrously ambitious bridge from traditional materials. Initially, he favoured Breedon stone, but on advice from specialists that it could crumble like cheese, he sought alternative materials. Astonishingly, he was on the point of ordering another type of stone when he made a shocking discovery. The supply was cursed. Any stonemason using it risked the ultimate sacrifice. Undaunted, he looked abroad and is now believed to be importing some 400,000 tons of weathered stone from ancient quarries originally discovered by the Pharaohs, but now part of the multinational Burroughs Corporation, somewhere in the Middle East. And on the advice of local shop-fitting craftsmen, he's sticking it all together with something a good deal more contemporary. Ever innovative, Edwards is using expanding foam and sellotape. It sounds spectacular, and even as I speak, the ground is quite literally being prepared. Over on the fourth, you can probably hear the distant booms as the footings are being blasted out. The workforce too, many of them press-ganged into service by Edwards from a Nottingham Technical College, is already assembling in the car park. It's a mammoth undertaking, and one which, given Edwards' problems in sourcing the stone, might still not be over by Christmas. That's the concern of a local bridge enthusiast and artist at Maxton Johnson Bench Associates, who's requested that his identity remain secret due to fear of reprisals.
I think there could be a big, big problem for him with that dodgy stone and the curse. That cursed stone he bought.
Well, he never actually bought it, did he? He looked elsewhere in the end. But then it's more than possible that that supply could be cursed as well, isn't it?
Absolutely. I think he's been off to Egypt or something or other. You hear these stories about Tutankhamun, is it? Maybe it's a cursed stone from one of his tombs.
Well, yes, indeed. I can see how that might worry anybody. An ancient curse like that could literally turn someone grey overnight, I suppose.
Well, to be quite honest, old Isambard, he's been dyeing his hair for a long, long time now. He went grey, I believe, in his early 20s. If you've noticed just recently, he's actually nearer a very, very sort of dark brunette, isn't he? So, and I think it suits him. And also, I don't know whether you've noticed, but his teeth are starting to become more white, pearly white.
Yes, but surely there's no way that Grecian 2000 and flashing teeth can hold up a project of this size, is there? Your timescale worries must have more substance than that, I would have thought.
Well, I think there might be another reason why there could be a delay, and that is old Isambard never does any more than about 4 hours a day work. That's his full day. I mean, he goes on about how little he charges people, but that's all relative to the length of time the lazy bugger actually works. So I think it's going to take twice as long as everybody's expecting, but we're just going to have to wait and see.
And whatever does happen, we'll be reporting on it and keeping you up to date. As you can probably hear in the background, building the road link to the fourth tee has already started, so we can expect heavy plant to be rolling in within the next fortnight or so. Until then, it's goodbye from me at the site of the Edwards Memorial Bridge near Nottingham.